The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. The words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., etched on the ribs of one Ohio football captain, stand true to this day. 5 years ago, Tim Edmond was part of the Bobcats recruiting class, but his grades weren't high enough. He found himself at Hutchinson Community College in Kansas to improve his academics. Being away from his home of Cincinnati was a challenge to the young athlete.
It was times where, you know, the whole entire summer for me to graduate, I had to stay there, and I was like the only one in the dorms, literally. You know what I'm saying? I didn't get home. I didn't go home from like May all the way to December when I graduated. So it was real self-motivated. It was times where, you know, you felt bad, you know, you start thinking about a lot of stuff. You want to go home, you get the jitters, because you Dorothy away from Kansas, from Cincinnati. So, you know, there's a lot of self-motivation.
While some junior college athletes cannot find the strength to make it to compete at the Division I level, Edmond took advantage of the opportunity to get better.
It's a privilege, man. It's a second chance. You know, you got a lot of guys in JUCO that really, on the real tip, have probably way more talent than some people that, you know, got the D1, but because of their background, they didn't have the self-motivation, you know what I'm saying, to keep going. They didn't have the background, the family, or whatever, to keep going. You know, I only had my brother and my mother at the time. So with that being said, it was just, you know what I'm saying, it's kind of a blessing in disguise, and you don't realize it. Like, man, I have to really graduate from JUCO, because a lot of people don't.
Edmond made it out of JUCO and returned to the Bobcats in 2012, filling in wherever there was a need on the depth chart. For his final year with Ohio, his teammates voted him team captain. As a running back, he earned his first career touchdown against Central Michigan.
It's kind of a personal vendetta, because, you know, I mean, you expect to get it. You know, it's your senior year, you become captain, everything just happened to you, and then, you know, not even going, you know, be in school about it, because you kind of can't control it. You know, it's, you know, you just keep busting in practice, and, you know, hopefully when Coach Alvin give me a shot, you know, I get in there and I do the best that I can do.
Edmond's tattoo, along with the rest of his body art, provides a constant reminder of his journey.
I got that tattoo based on, you know, it ain't what you do when coaches are looking at you, it's what they do when they aren't looking at you. So all my tattoos are motivational. It'd be times where we'll be on 16-100, on 110s, and I just look down like, okay, like, get up, let's get this on.
As Edmond looks at his tattoos for motivation, his teammates rely on his vocal leadership before games.
It's time, baby.
Everything that I say, whether I'm mumbling or stuttering, you know, they would it, you know what I'm saying? They ready to, you know, go to war for me on the field, you know, whether it's cold, hot, chilly, tornado, they there for me.
Start time!
Let's go!
Let's get this,
man.
Let's go! Mac Temps, man! 1-0-3! 1-2-3!
1-0!